Morning guys, an absolutely gorgeous day here in Shanghai. Today I'm heading to Yew Gardens and some temple that I can't remember the name of, but it's next to it, so I don't exactly know where Yew Gardens is, so I've got to look on the map and find out. Made it into a temple. And, it's pretty nice, all of the roofs are like gold. But the only problem is, like, you can see Shanghai towering over it. So it kind of takes away from the atmosphere, but it's nice anyway. Temple. It was okay. Nothing on the temples in Beijing. It's quite expensive compared to ones in Beijing as well. No, there wasn't a light in there. And also, it's a very modern built temple. All the outside decorations are all pretty here and stuff like that. On the inside, it's basically just grey concrete, like it's plain concrete. So, yeah, it was okay. Yeah, just come into the park over the road now. So managed to make it to just outside the gardens, where the gardens are. It's a really nice little, kind of like a hutong. But it's all shops and sort of food shops and stuff like that. As I walked out the metro, I got a map out and was looking at the map to see exactly where it was. And these two Chinese, this girl and a guy, Chinese guy, come up to me. And he says, "Mal, can you take a photo?" I was like, "Yeah, no problem." Took a photo to him and got talking to him. And they invited me to, they were going to a tea ceremony, and they invited me along. I was like, "Yeah, why not?" It was really nice, got a chance with them. They were cousins. They taught me some Chinese and stuff like that. We went into the tea ceremony and sat down and tried some teas, and it was really, really nice just to like speak to some local. Well, they're not local, they're here on a holiday. It was really expensive, like, considering I got the same thing pretty much in Beijing, which for free, just tasting teas. So, it was about 40 quid for the tea ceremony, which is a lot of money. But I'm gonna go into the gardens now and then come out and I'll get some food probably. Oh, and they also they said, "Oh, do I have a map so I can point out stuff for me to do?" I was like, "Yeah." And they circled pretty much everything on the map that I need to go to and I need to see, and yeah, they're really, really nice. Yeah, it was good. But yeah, into the gardens, I think, now. So yeah, just going over to the entrance and get a ticket. And go in. Markets near the park the last sort of 20 minutes, half hour. Pretty cool. There's lots of people selling fake stuff. So, I'll try and get you to come like around the back for watches and bags and all that kind of stuff. Now we're going to head back into next to the park area and grab something to eat and head off somewhere else, I think. Oh, So I just walked down to People's Square, I think it's called. There's fountains and a building over there, and also the Shanghai Museum on the other side. There's some gardens around it, stuff like that. Just going to head back to my hostel now, try and edit a video and try and get one up as well. Got a really great connection at the hostel, but for some reason I can't connect to the VPN, so I don't know. But there's two different Wi-Fi's. There's a different Wi-Fi for the communal area down in the lobby, and there's a it's different to the ones that are in your room. So I might go and sit down in the lobby and try and connect down there. So hopefully I'll be able to, so I can get a video up. And it, like I said, it's a good connection. So hopefully it shouldn't take too long. It'll probably take about half hour if I can get connected properly. So yeah, it'll be good. So hopefully I can get a couple up. It'll be good. But we'll see. Let's head back. I'm not sure whether I have to take a metro or not. I'm not sure how far I've walked and how far I've got to go, really. I have to check the map quickly and then decide. Okay, so just checking the map, and it's definitely not within walking distance. This is where I walked from, and this is where I am now. And that's my hostel, so like that much distance. So yeah, I'm definitely gonna have to get a metro. So yeah, the metro is a lot different here to Beijing. You have to pay for the journey that you take, as opposed to just getting a ticket and hopping on. So it's different. Like, it's only, well, the maximum I've paid so far is 4 won, and the minimum I've paid is 3. But yeah, you can only buy a ticket for the journey that you do. So you have to use the machines all the time, as opposed to just going to a counter and getting a ticket. It's a lot easier, and the metro is a lot harder to use. Like, I don't know whether it's because they had the games in Beijing in 2008. I think that's probably got a lot to do with them updating everything and making everything like English sort of thing and easy to read and stuff like that. I think that's probably got a lot to do with it. But yeah, gonna head back to the hostel now, and well, I'll probably see you in a second, but probably a couple of hours for me. Right, that took a hell of a lot longer than I thought it did. It's now 10 o'clock at night. Yeah, it took about 4 hours of disconnecting and reconnecting, and the VPN disconnecting the reconnect it, and like the later it got, the more people were coming down and using the internet. So yeah, it's become more and more unstable. I managed to get it up just in time, because sort of managed to post it and stuff like that, and then literally I couldn't connect to the internet at all, so it was like perfect timing, really. But yeah, glad to get it up. It was a Trans-Siberian one, so yes, such a good video. I love that video. I'm going to Suzhou tomorrow, which is a water town. I'm gonna take a train there, but I'm also leaving tomorrow night for Xi'an, so I'm gonna have to check out in the morning, early in the morning, and then go to Shanghai train station, leave my stuff there. There's like cloakrooms there you can leave your stuff at, and then go to Suzhou, and then come back, making sure that I leave enough time to get the train to Xi'an. So if I miss it, then I'll have to stay here another night, and that won't be ideal.
Because that means I'll have to pay for
another night's hostel here, and I'm pretty much done with Shanghai, to be honest. It was okay. Probably wouldn't come back in a hurry. It's mostly come here for shopping. Like, pretty much everyone in the hostel seems to be coming here to go out drinking. So that's not really what I want to do while travelling. But yeah, that's what other people want to do. That's up to them, sort of thing. So, it's been okay. A few of the sights were nice. I think I've pretty much done most of them a day. I mean, you probably could, if you wanted to, do all of the tourist attractions in a day, and like the rest of it's just shops or bars, or depending on what you want to do. Say goodnight now, guys. Gonna go in early night so I can get up as early as possible. Probably get up about 5:30, to make sure I can get to Suzhou early, and then make Shanghai so I can get back early in time for the train. Obviously when I get to the train station, I've got to book the tickets. And there probably won't be, or there might be an English speaking person there, hopefully. We'll have to see. But yeah, I'm going to say goodnight, guys. Thanks for watching again. And don't forget to subscribe if you want to follow the travels around. And I'll catch you next time.